I'm Mike.
Hey, what's up? I'm Sean. We're from Small Pools, and this is Ellenwood TV.
Time has been moving rapidly for Small Pools. Is that the name right? A month ago exactly, you were performing your debut show at the Brooklyn Ball, only to begin a 10-city tour with San Francisco 2 days later. Can you elaborate on how fast things are moving for you guys and what the best, what the past month has meant for you as rising stars?
Since we first launched our initial song to the world, it has been moving really quickly. Like, we definitely didn't expect such an awesome response so quickly. But we did get in a room like about a year ago now in August. So we've kind of been like developing our sound and songs behind the scenes for the past year. And we had some demos that kind of didn't make the cut. So it has been like a gradual thing for us. But yeah, like once we actually push play, like things have been really crazy. So.
The song Dreaming placed you on a national audience stage, generating enough attention to release last month's self-titled EP. What has been the reaction from critics and most importantly fans around here that have come across from the EP?
The reaction has been really good.
We were really excited to get the EP out because we put Dreaming out and it was the only thing that existed from our band for about a month or so. So
once you only have one thing in the world, like people just kind of, you know, hear that as the sound of your band, and people make comparisons, and they didn't pull you as that one thing. So we wanted to kind of, you know, get
that rest as possible, so we can.
But they were not exactly what you think it was going to be, you know.
Yeah, but I mean, we on the tour we had actually a couple of headliners that we were kind of scared of. You know, we've been a band for 2 months, but it was crazy that, you know, people came out and were singing, and dreaming, and going crazy. So.
Can you share any specific influences that have led to where your music is now?
I think kind of moving out to Cali and just kind of like...
Cali!
I don't know, there's just like a vibe and like an inspiration. Like we were both living in the East Coast. Cole Winters living at home in my hometown. Just like this little bubble where everybody knew everybody. And once we kind of got out here in the world and like tried to do this thing, it was just like this overall mood. It was kind of like carefree and whatever, like let's just do this thing and it happens to happen. I think that has a lot to do with it.
Right. A lot of our favorite songs are songs that kind of make you feel good, you know, the songs that we grew up listening to, we're still listening to today, that kind of stood the test of time. Just listen to feel good music and wanted to send out positivity.
Great, great.
Even though all the lyrics aren't positive, but not negative.
According to your tour dates, aside from the one that you have in September, I think it's back in San Francisco, this is pretty much here for LA. What can fans expect for the remainder of 2013 as for tour dates?
Tour dates.
Well, actually that show in September is in LA.
Okay, cool.
So we're going to be doing that. We're going to be out with a band called Walk the Moon, which should be awesome. Doing a leg on that. Something else after that, but I don't think it'll be announced yet. But we'll be hitting most markets before the end of the year, possibly to like the UK and then.
Oh, awesome.
Yeah, but definitely the main focus is fiction.
It seems like your lyrics are crafted on 8x10 college ruled paper.
Yeah.
And that just came on photos that I found online.
Right.
Have you ever experienced a moment where it's late at night and you see like a tissue or a napkin and you got this like lyric in your head that you have to write down, or you're at a bar and you're writing something down, or how does writing process
happens,
work?
It happens all the time. Like maybe it'll be some like phrase or something that is just really cool. I mean, since it's 2013, I whip out the iPhone and put it on a memo or like record a voice memo or something.
I know for no story time, we need one last line, so like the fourth song on our EP, and we just like had the whole song done, so this one line, and I think like one of us came up with it, like walking into a bar, just like recorded it, probably kind of buzzed, and we like went back and listened to it next day, we're like, alright, it kind of works, so.
Yeah, no, that definitely happens.
So yes is the answer.
And the written down thing is just to make sure everyone knows what the actual lyrics are.
Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, any social media, people are asking if an LP is in the works, and I heard you guys talking about an album that you're working on. What's the status on it?
Status is tough. We've been working on it simultaneously with the EP. Like, the EP was just kind of like the first four songs that were ready to push through the line. But there's definitely a whiteboard with a bunch of song skeleton ideas. We're home now, so we're going to go back and start working on it. And when we're not on the road, that's pretty much all we're doing. So I don't have a timeline. I would think like early next year.
I think we're just going to keep working on songs, and then when someone's like, all right guys, it's time to put this out, and then come out.
So we can work on it for the next 10 years.
Right.
No one booked us.
Just call it Chinese Democracy Part 2.
Yes, exactly.
All right, guys, thank you so much for your
time.
Thank you so much. I'm sure you guys are going to kick ass tonight,
yeah.
And we'll see you next week.
Yeah.